Okay, what's up everyone? ADS Play 101 here, and welcome to my, I guess you could say, impromptu review of the Sandlands demo. Now, normally, I think I don't really do like demos for, like reviews for demos, but considering how this is like a special case, I think I should. First off, Sandland is a new anime slash game that was created by Akira Toriyama before his passing. So this is like his, almost like his swan song. This is like his last gift to us as fans of like Chrono Trigger, Dragon Ball, Dragon Quest, etc. The game, well, the demo, you know, again, keep in mind, this is a demo. So obviously, hopefully the full game is better, but I said at the beginning of this demo playthrough that I felt like it was going to be some elements that I wasn't going to like, and that turned out to be true with the demo that I hope that they fix in the full game. First off, the vehicle controls are bad in this game, and I'm just speaking on the negatives first. The vehicle controls on the motorcycle and the tank aren't that good, because the way they designed it is that you have to hold forward on the analog in order to go forward and basically hold back. But sometimes when you have the camera turned, it'll go in the opposite direction. And it's like when you're in the middle of a fight or when you're trying to get away, at times the controls don't seem to work best for those type of situations. The battle armor has the best controls in my opinion, because you have more control over your movements. There are cliffs in this demo, like hills. Well, they call them hills, but they're like, you know, cliffs, like rocky cliffs. that you can jump up and there's items on top. The problem with that is that with the exception, as far as the demo goes, with the exception of probably one, the rest of them you can't get to. That you just can't get to them. They expect you to be able to use the battle armor, which is the only vehicle that you have that can jump in the demo. They expect you to use it to jump to get up to those bigger heights, but the machine doesn't jump up that high. It jumps right at the edge, and it doesn't grab the edge to like try to pull itself up or anything. And your character doesn't even have the ability to jump that high, even though he has double jump. So maybe in the full game they'll have something to upgrade where you can increase your jump height. But right now it's just like, it's just stupid. Another thing is that, and this is kind of like a love-hate thing, I feel like when it comes to games like this, there's no clear sense of direction, right? Like, the intention of the game is for you to explore on your own and to figure things out on your own. And for some people, you know, especially if you're used to, like, Dark Souls or like, you know, like, Demon Souls or anything like that, where you, or, like, Elden Ring, or games that are, that have, like, this, this element of exploration to it, to where you have to figure out on your own where to go next. That's kind of like a love-hate thing, and this game kind of, at least from the demo, kind of lends itself towards that. This may or may not change in the full game, which I doubt it will, but I can see how some people can get frustrated with this, because it's not completely obvious as to where you're supposed to go next. Like, you have to explore and figure that out on your own, so that could be a very tedious thing for somebody. They have an autopilot feature, which I guess is just supposed to help you like drive around to your next destination, but it never worked for me. The autopilot just kind of just went forward. So who knows if that's going to change in the main game. Other than that, I mean, I like the character designs. I like, where it seems like the story is headed. this post-apocalyptic wasteland where people are trying to survive with water. It seemed like the demons took over, and they're trying to explore and figure things out. I kind of like that aspect of it. The anime for this is nice, but I did get kind of frustrated with the game. With the demo, I got frustrated with it. So I'm hoping that the main game gives me a better experience. You know, this is Akira Toriyama's last gift to the fans of his work, and I would hate for this game to be like garbage. You know what I mean? Because I'm gonna be honest, bro. Like, if the full game gives me the same vibes as the demo, if they don't improve on what the demo didn't give me, then I'm gonna have some negative things to say about it. You know, like, there's action in it, but of course it was gonna be repetitive. But granted, they only gave you access to only three vehicles: a motorcycle, a battle tank, and a battle and like a mech suit. So obviously, like, you're limited on where you can go and what you can do. But the things that they want you to do in this game, they don't really allow you to do it. Again, like, the jumping could be better, especially if they expect you to use it to get to higher grounds. The they could have fixed this up better. So I'm gonna just leave that there. So with that being said, man, I mean, it's a demo, you know, like, we'll see what the full game is like. But as far as the demo goes, this thing was a headache. I won't lie to you. It's a headache. Some people, I'm pretty sure they might have been able to figure it out, but the average person, I can guarantee you, is going to have difficulty trying to figure this out. So hopefully the full game gives a better experience. So that was my thoughts on the Sandland demo. Hopefully, like I said, hopefully the main game gives a better experience. And I will see you guys later. Peace.